Okay, don't get caught out like I did building these slimline cabinets. Now this bracket here has to be down here. These are the instructions for installing the door and putting the hinges on. And the actual instructions, the cabinet is upside down. There's a little note that says top of cabinet just there. So this is actually the top of the cabinet, and as you can see on the instructions, they've got it upside down. That's confusing. That's promoting confusion. And getting back to the building of the cabinet, there's no clue where to put the where these go, which way the end, the sides are flipped. So I've got to put this one over there, flip it and put it on the other side, and these are the instructions for building the cabinet, and there's no clue except these three very small little holes just above my finger there. I've had a look through the instructions and there's no note anywhere saying that to keep the hinge bracket and the oil compression holder. To line it up properly. There's nothing anywhere that says that these have to be down the bottom of either side of the cabinet. This is really ridiculous. I mean, I drive a truck around the CBD for a living, and I've got to correct a multi-million dollar company's instructions. So this is what this should look like. That's the cabinet. That's the top of it. That's what you see from the ground. And they're referring to the hinge to push it in, to connect it. And I've got a connection diagram there. That's what it needs to be, that the door's opening this way. And that's the way you're seeing it throughout the instructions, not upside down like that. And these are the instructions for the cabinet. There should be a diagram saying, note, install sides with slimline cabinet hinge connection on underside of cabinet, in brackets either side. So that's where the connection has to be. Not up there. I could also do something like that with a cross and a tick. Yeah, and as I say, I'm a truck driver on $23 an hour. Okay, so there's the strut, and you'll see that's the type of ball joint there. Now what you have to do, and there's no instructions for this, you got to get a specialist little screwdriver. It's not a Phillips head screwdriver, it's just a normal old-fashioned one, and it's got a ridge there. It's got a ridge underneath there where you can get it underneath that metal bit, and it's got a ridge on the other side where you can get it underneath the metal bracket. And so by getting it under and pulling it back, you open up that ball joint. So thin edge, thin side goes on top, just bring back that ball joint like that, and as you can see, you can't push it on. You can get something in behind the metal frame there, and then you're able to just push it on. Okay, so that's the instructions for attaching the gas strut. It's a diagram of it connected here at the back and off, and here
It's connected up here and it's attached there. That's it. That's like getting a new car and it's got instructions how to use it, and it's got a door open and then a door closed. And I don't think anyone would have much success if they showed the diagram of the car upside down. Okay, so now it's time to just fix the benches in place. I'll be fixing them by the underneath. I'll be fixing with these small L brackets that came with the screws, and then gluing and just installing the top layer. On this side, the east side, it doesn't quite make it. The bench doesn't quite make it, so I've just got to put a little bit of a fill in here. And on the other side, the east wall of the bench makes it from one side to the other. It's got a 10mm overhang and a trim will be fixed around the sides, a tiled top and a tiled back. These L brackets, they just sit under there like that. Funnily enough, I've got 2x6 L brackets, so 6 for either side, so I'll go and buy some more, but to start off with I'll be fixing 4 on either side and probably 2 in the middle somewhere. Okay, so now I'm just fixing the bench top to the cabinets. Okay, so now the first bench is secured to the cabinets, and I'll go ahead now and fit the second bench. Okay, I've got my bench marked all the way along, and put 3 along this area here where the cooktop sits, and now I'll go ahead and countersink all the holes and drill them.
Okay, the east wall bench is on, and now for the west wall. I'm cleaning the underneath with soapy water. Okay, that's the bench tops, and it's time for tiling. Okay, so that's about the fourth tile I've got to cut, and it's not easy because I've got to cut this bit out of it, and that bit's got to stay in one piece. I've gone and got a new grinder blade, so I'd say that's the best approach, is just to dry cut it with a diamond tipped blade.
Okay, so that's one side and one more side to go. To get the round I need for the kitchen bench here, I've got to be 10mm within this line, so it sort of goes around like that. What I did was I just laid the tile in place, I got underneath and traced it from underneath, and I measured out from the corner to about there, 10mm past the line, and I should be right to cut it. I'm not going to round the corners off for the trough because, as you can see, there's plenty of area here for it to go straight across.